Of all days, we thank you for the privilege given us, O God, to gather before you. Thank you for whom you are, who you've been, who you forever be. Thank you for being the God, the Lord of our lives. Lord, receive all the praise, receive all the honor, receive all the adorations. Thank you, Father, for being the only one that truly cares for us. No matter how anyone try, no one can ever be like you. So therefore, we say glory, honor, power, majesty, adoration, be ascribed to you and to you alone in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, behold your little children, we have come to hear from you, not from man. Lord, I ask, O God, you search me, what is that song word you have against me that is saying, my son, even if you are preaching now, you are a candidate of hell. You are a worker of iniquity. Papa, please have mercy upon me. Forgive me, purify me, purge me, make me holy in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Holy Spirit of the Lord God Almighty, I surrender unto you. I have no word of my own. I don't know my left or my right. I totally depend on you. Please take over the hearts of your children.
Amen.
Let the heart be fertile for your word to enter.
Amen.
Lord, take over my tongue. Use my tongue as the tongue of the learned. To the end that we all shall be blessed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Father. Because I know every form of discipline is going to be arrested in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Welcome again to the presence of the Most High. I come to hear from our Father, the word of light, the word of admonition, the word of keep it going and keep it going. One of the reasons why some people cannot stand for the truth is what the Lord is about to tell us now. The reason why some people are afraid to stand out, afraid to stand for Jesus, so that what the Holy Spirit is about to speak about will not happen to them. But glory be to God. Have given us power over it. As many of us who are still in that situation, the Lord God Almighty, in His mercy, shall deliver you and deliver every soul on this mountain in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The message for this morning is titled, Action Over Here, Overcoming Hatred and Rejection. Overcoming hatred and rejection. As I said before, the reason why some people cannot speak the truth, because most time hatred can stir up anger. The truth can stir up anger in the heart of men. If you are somebody who speaks the truth, you must be ready to be hated. If you are somebody who is standing by the truth, be ready to gather enemies around you. And this is one reason why some people cannot be in spirit. It's why so many men of God today, so many Christians, prefer to walk in the flesh. You know why? In the flesh, you can be friends to anybody. But you, when you are a man of the spirit, if you are somebody who puts your ear in the mouth of God, be ready to be hated by people. Because no matter how people want to celebrate you, when they don't give you a word for them, and that word is a bombshell, hatred will come. So therefore, you and I, if we want to enter God's kingdom, we must be ready to be hated and be rejected of men. Brethren, the Bible told you and I in the book of Luke, chapter 6. Luke 6, verse 22 and 23. Say, blessed are ye when men shall hate you. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you. Now, ask yourself, why will men hate you? If they hate you for your evil deed, their hating you is justified. I'm talking about hating you for being a child of God, hating you for doing the right thing. Blessed are ye when you are right with God and you are wrong in the eyes of men. Blessed are ye when Christ is celebrating you and men are hating you. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you. And this is what people don't want to see. And when they shall separate you from their company. No, we don't want this man here. We don't want this man here. Why? Because of his or her lifestyle. Because we know he will expose us. Because we know he will not join us in our evil deeds. When they shall separate you from the company and shall reproach you and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake, they shall uproot you from among them. Why? Because of your love for the truth. Why? Because of your love for your Father. Because you don't want to do what they are doing. 23. Rejoice. Rejoice, yea, in that day. And leap for joy. Rejoice when you are hated. For Christ's sake. And leap for joy. For behold, your reward is great in heaven. Let them go away with their reward. Let them go with their flattery. Let them go with whatever they wanted to give you. Maybe somebody come to you, they come with whatever gift, and in the process, the Lord speak to you about them. It's better they go back with that gift than to drop the gift for you, and you are now an enemy of God. It's better you say the truth, and they go with that gift of doom, than they give the gift, lie to them, and you are now a rebel before God. Why? He said, your reward is great in heaven. For in the like manner did their father unto the prophet. This is how Jeremiah was being punished for being truthful. Ezekiel, Isaiah, every prophet that ever came, because of standing for the truth, they punished them, they banished them, they arrested them. The Lord is saying, you and I must also be able to do what they did, to stand for the truth. For our reward is great in heaven. The Bible now says in verse 26, that says Luke 6. He said, woe unto you when all men shall speak well of you. Ah, that man of God is so wonderful. Why? Because even if you marry two wives, doesn't care. Oh, that man of God is so loving, man of God. Why? Because even though you're a second wife, he doesn't care. Even though you divorce and marry somebody else, he doesn't care. Hey, you are a wonderful daughter. Hey, my Deaconess, how are you? Deaconess, who is a second wife? So such a man of God is being praised by everybody. Such a sister who don't care, that close eyes against him, is being celebrated. But the Bible says, woe unto you when men shall praise you for you not telling the truth. Woe unto you when men shall clap for you when Christ is crying and weeping. Woe unto you, O ye man of God, that see your member doing evil and yet you close your eyes on them. Why? Because you did tithe, offering a gift. Now, I wonder if the Lord said, woe unto you, where else are you going to? Woe unto you when men, When your father and your mother that praise you, when you know that what they are doing is evil, you can't tell them. Woe unto you when your wife is in prostitution and you close your mouth because you are eating the money. Woe unto you. Woe unto you when men say, ah, this man is a very rich man. I know that richness is of the devil. Woe unto you, say the Lord. When all men shall speak well of you, for so did their father to the false prophet. Hey, our pastor is a very good pastor. He loves all the youth. He pets all the, no matter what the youth is doing, ah, the man is so lovely. Our pastor is so lovely. You see the youth fornicating, he doesn't care. It is well with you, okay? Don't worry. I know in the process of that graduate, you people will become, you know. Is he your girlfriend or are you people just man of God? Is your girlfriend, please, don't just take it easy, eh? Yes, man of God. Yes, man of God. God, yes, man of God, you are doomed. The Bible says, woe unto you. Woe unto you. And men shall love you. Brethren, it doesn't matter how much effort one puts into work to please people. Those who hate you, we rather hate you the more than to appreciate your work. This is why you must not do anything to please people. Those who will not love you will not love you. No matter, use your head for them, they will not love you. Let me start doing this way so that people start appreciating me. You are only sending your soul to hell. If Christ was not loved by people he died for, who is me for people to be loved? If Christ was not able to penetrate the heart of men, he fed them. He raised death. Even in John chapter 11, while he was still raising Lazarus, people were still hating him at that moment. People were still hating him while he brought Percy back to life. So there's nothing you can do to make your haters love you. If you go out of the way to make them hate you, I mean to love you, maybe they will love you, but your soul is in danger. The Bible told me, and you in Matthew chapter 13, verse 54 to 57. And when he was come into his own country, I'm talking about Christ now. He taught them in their synagogue. He taught them, he never stole from them. He taught them in their synagogue, in as much that they were astonished and said, whence had this man this wisdom and these mighty works? Verse 55. Is not this carpenter's son? Is not his mother called Mary? And his brethren, James and Joseph and Simon and Judah? 56. And his sister, are they not all with us? When then had this man all these things? They were not concerned about his teaching. They were concerned about his background. They were concerned about who is this person. What he was telling them does not matter to them. What he was doing does not matter. What matter to them is who this man is. And they were offended in him. Where were they offended? What did he do now that they were offended? But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, save in his own country and in his own house. He did everything to please his own people. You that want to pull drug, you want to do prostitution to please your people. If you die in it, they will drop you that hole. You're finished. You that's living to please people, all your life is how to please human beings. I pity you. Christ did everything to teach them. He performed a miracle in their eyes, but yet he could not please them. All they were concerned about is his background. And he said, a prophet is not without honor, save his own country and his own house. You think they are honoring you? You think they love you? When you are not doing what they are doing, they will never ever love you. They will never ever. They will just only close their eyes to take that thing from you. And where they are sending you to is where they are sending you to. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want you to understand, you that want to live your life to please people, not to please God. You cannot please anyone that has rejected you. Whoever, except the Lord himself, deliver you from their hand. So long their heart is sealed against you, the more you are giving them, the more they're hating you. The devil has sealed up the heart of man. No matter what Christ do for them, go to America today, no matter what Donald Trump do, because the Democrats, they hate him, no matter what, if he say, if you go this way, they go that way. If you do good things, they'll use bad things. They'll look for one thing to spread that good thing you have done. So therefore, don't try to leave your life to somebody. Overcome that hatred. Don't say, I don't want to be hated, so let me blend. You cannot blend. I don't want to be rejected. I don't want to be left alone. It's better you are left alone with your God than you are in the midst of wolves. At the end, the wolf, they will still destroy you. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says, no matter what David did to make someone, to make Saul happy, he could not. All that was in the heart of Saul was to pierce him. This is a young man that was seeking for you, for demons to leave you. This is a young man praying all the time to make sure you are well. All you are planning is how to destroy him. That is what is still going on today. Just do what you are doing because of God, not because of man. Why? Man will always be man. The Bible says in 1 Samuel 18, 11, and Saul cast the javelin, for he said, I will smite David even to the wall with it. What did David do? And David avoided out of his presence twice. And Saul was afraid of David because the Lord was with him and was departed from Saul. Is the Lord with you? Avoid those who want to destroy you. Do you know that God is with you? Forget about them hating you. Keep on making your God proud. Keep on doing what you please your father. You know why? The more you please them, the more they are getting mistakes from you. How can this young man who that was brought when you are manned, this young man will play to hear you? Why is playing? You are set your devil to pierce him. Why? Because of the presence of God in him. Light and darkness can never meet. When you are of God, the world must hate you. There's nothing you can do about it. When you are a holy man of God, the rest, the ones working for the other man, they must hate you. So trying to blend with them, you are only endangering your soul. People of the world must hate you. So try to make yourself known. They will pierce their sword into you, and if you die, your soul is wasted forever. Brethren, trying to do things to please humanity as a Christian is a spiritual suicide. Trying to live your life to please people, you are embarking on suicide mission. Trying to please the people of this world, let me preach so that people will love me, so that the ministry will be full, so that many people will be following me. I want to have more subscribers on YouTube. So let me lower the standard. I want many people to follow me on Facebook. So let's lower the standard. As you lower the standard, you are just step out of the way of heaven. They'll clap for you into your doom. And when you know it, they'll make a bishop. When you know it, they put small cap on your head. Let's put small cap. Put small cap on your head and give you one big chain. And you are doomed forever. So what do you do? Stand. Fear not rejection. Fear not hatred. I'm here to tell you, no matter how you try, they must hate you so long you are not in their line. They must hate you. They must reject you. You are rejected of the world. The world can never love you again. There's a line between you and the world, except you now leave God and go to them. But saying you're going to serve God and have a relationship with the world is a lie. It's not possible. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Amen.
Amen.
This is exactly what I want to talk about now. The man who is preaching now, they are removing YouTube, but no problem. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So please the word. Is a spiritual suicide. The Bible told us in John chapter number 15, 18 to 21. If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. Can't you understand now? If the world cannot love your master, you think they can love you? It's not possible. Except you are a child of the devil. The only reason the world can put red carpet on the floor for you is when you are an agent of the devil. It's when you are a wolf in sheep clothing. Verse 19. If you were of the world would have loved his own. Are you of the world? So why are you seeking love of the world? The world would have loved his own. Since I am not of the world, why am I trying to make them love me? It's not possible. Oil and water cannot blend. Light and darkness cannot work together. But I have chosen you out of the world. Therefore, the world hated you. Except you are not really born again. Except you are not truly a child of God. If you are, the world must hate you. If you are, this world can never love you again. There's a thin line between you and the world. The line is drawn. Our Lord Jesus Christ has drawn a thin line between you and the world. He has put you out. So try to blend with them. Try to say things to make them happy. You are only endangering your soul. Verse 20. Remember the word that I said unto you. The servant is not greater than his Lord. If the Lord Jesus Christ could not penetrate the world to love him, is it me now? If when he raised the dead, he healed the sick, and he even died for them, and yet he could not make them love him, is it me? What miracle will I ever perform now that the world will ever love me? What will Apostle Emmanuel ever do that Christ never did, that they will love me? There's nothing. So trying to make you or the world love me is suicidal. I'm telling myself, I don't want to go back to my father. So, if they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you. And this is what so many men of God don't want to see. They don't want the government to hate them. They don't want the people to hate them, so they have to be motivational. They have to preach love. Don't preach anything that will offend anybody. If they kept my word, my saying, they will keep yours also. 21, but all these things will they do unto you for my name's sake, because they know not him that sent me. They will do it. Why? Because you are a child of God. Except you are trying to stand on the fence, you are neither here or there. And if you are such a Christian, I pity you. Your portion in hell is deep down there. So you must draw a thin line between you and the world. You must be known for the truth wherever you go. Don't try to know to put water in your mouth. Say the truth. Let them hate you for a season. Let the man do my hate you. It's better people run away from you for the truth than people gather around you for your lies. It's better those who were blessed you before stop blessing because of the truth than they are sending you gift of doom for you living the way of the truth. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Your own family, they think, will accept you easily. It's where the force of rejection is even stronger, when you are the Lord. Friends, you think, if I just go to them and tell them, they will accept me. Be ready. Those people, you think, they know me. If I just come out, they will be ready. That is where the hatred is even stronger. The devil will seal them up against you. So, stand your ground. For salvation is personal. The Bible says in John chapter 1, verse 11, he come unto his own, and his own receive him not. He came to those he created, they rejected him. He came to his own children, they rejected him. So, if you go and preach to your people, they reject you. You are not the first person. They also did this to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So, don't die to make people love you. Do what the Spirit, that's why we must be in spirit all the time. Do what the Spirit says you should do and take your mind away from people. Pray the prayers that you pray. Just make sure you are in the land of God. If you are doing it so that you want to win praise of men, you will kill yourself, you will drop in that grave and run away to somebody else. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, envy and jealousy could also arise among blood relatives, even among your brothers. Being a child of God can stir up envy and jealousy. The Bible says they killed Christ for what? For envy and jealousy. Why did they envy him? Because of the light of God in him. Because he was never like them. He never blended there with the Pharisees. No. He never blended there with the Sadducees. No. He was distinguished. He was a distinguished gentleman. While he was on earth, he never lived to please them, never. And for that reason, they stir up anger. What kind of man is this? What kind of a young boy is this? And out of envy, they arrested him and slaughtered him. Let's say they will do the same thing with you. But then the Bible says in Genesis chapter 37, verse 3 and 4. Now, Israel loved Joseph more than all his children. We're talking about overcoming hatred and rejection. Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a coat of many colors. Christ loved you because you are his daughter. And he gave you salvation. He put the truth in your mouth. For that reason, anger stepped up. Jealousy stepped up. He gave you one sweet voice. He put you in that chair. Envy stepped up. Anger stepped up. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than them, all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. Who cares? Carry your words to that side. The more you don't even talk to me, the more I have time to pray with my father. That time you are able to talk to me, you might even be stopping me from hearing my father. So, talking not to me does not matter anything. Sometimes your talk to me can even become distraction. So don't be afraid. If I say this one, nobody will talk to me again. What? What is your business with that? They could not speak with him peaceably. They could not. Why? Because their father loved him. So also Christ loves you. Human being, we hate you. Then I come. It doesn't matter. Let them carry their face as if they are now frog. It doesn't matter. So long your love with God remain the same. So long that salvation that Christ has given to you, don't drop it for any reason. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You must be ready to stand and overcome hatred. You must be ready to stand and overcome rejection. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Ready to overcome rejection. They will reject you for that thing that Christ has given to you that they don't have. So, stay put with that thing that God has given to you. And let not your heart be troubled because you are rejected. For Christ has accepted you. Brethren, you only need the grace of God to survive hatred and rejection. All you need is the grace of God. Let the grace of God be abundant for you all the time. Say, Father, empower me more and more. The more people are hating you, the more you are hidden in the grace of God. The more people are trying to destroy, the more hide yourself in His grace. Or try to come out of Him to make people love you. You are on your way to the land of doom. That's why I take it out of the context in 2 Corinthians 12, 8, and 11. See, for this thing, I besought the Lord thrice that it might depart from me. I'm using it as another context now. Cry to God. Lord, help me. Help me to stand. I don't want to fail you and make my happy. Besought the Lord. The Lord might not stop them from hating you, but He will empower you with His grace. When He was on earth here, the grace of His Father was abundant in Him. His grace will also be there for you. Verse 9, and He said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ might rest upon me. Verse 10, therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessity, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. When men want to weaken you, be strong in the Lord. Be ready to bear persecution. Be ready to be hated. The more they are doing it to you, the more you are closer to God. So Lord, they are not hating for evil deed. Always set your conscience. Why are these people hating me? When you are convinced that it's because of the Lord, because of the truth, rejoice. For the Lord is happy over what they are angry of. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Men may reject you, but God will always stand out for you. Men may hate you, but the Lord will always comfort you. That's why the Bible says in Psalm 118, verse 22, the stone the builder rejected, the stone the builder refused, is become the head of stone of the corner. Are you being rejected? Don't worry. In no distant time, they will see. If you can bear it now, if you can be able to stand now, in no distant time, they will have no choice than to bow. The stone that the world rejected, He said Christ, and the whole world, they killed Him. Today He's been glorified. We get to 1 to 11. He stands glorified. He said to you, if you can stand in the time of rejection, you can stand when men are hitting you, the Lord will stand you out. So please, I'm begging you, don't try to be like them for you to be loved. Don't try to make them happy. Sorry, Ephesians 2. Don't try to make them happy for you to be loved. Ephesians 2, 1 to 11. Brethren, no one can be against you when God is with you. Except you are just being manipulative. Except you are an hypocrite. Except you are not really of the Lord. If actually you are of God, he will protect you. So strange things might happen. But I tell you, the Lord will stand for you. They might afflict you. But in that affliction, the Lord will bring you out stronger. They might pierce you with sword. They might say some things to you to put you down. If you are able to bear it, it can only be for a while. I tell you, in no certain time, the Lord will bring you out stronger again. That's why the Bible told us in that book, 1 Peter, chapter number 5, verse 10. Please, if you are there, please read it. 1 Peter 5, verse 10.
1 Peter 5:10. He said, "But the God of all grace, who had called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you." Amen.
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 There's no guarantee that you will not suffer. You will suffer. You will suffer hatred. You will suffer rejection. But he said, "He will what? Establish you. He will strengthen you. And it will settle you. Man cannot settle you. You hear me? Man cannot settle you. Woman, nobody can settle you. Only God can settle you. So why will you want to make people to love you, to settle you? No! They can only buy a gift for you. If you die, that gift is gone. Let me have 100 If now God call me with this one, this one will follow me. All the suit is now useless to me. Oh, let them be changing my car every day. I was this morning, I saw in news, in paper. Oh God, have mercy upon men of God. A man of God went to do plastic surgery, I don't know. Man of God, he allowed one stupid girl to brainwash him to say, "Man of God, you need to be more beautiful." So when he just stepped out, people say, "Yes, our pastor is an handsome man." Eh? Your mates are thinking about how to hear from the Lord. What message do you have for your people tomorrow? Who is that person you want to pray for? This man, all he was thinking about is how to be more handsome. And they carried him into the surgery. And while they were doing it, complication came in and he died. Tell me now, where is that man of God going to now? Sadie Joel, I am handsome or not, it's not your business.
Oh, very, very.
Uh-huh. It's not anybody's business. So long the word of it is handsome. So long what I'm doing is right with God. No matter how I look, it's not your business. After all, I'm married already. Eh? If I'm ugly, let it be for my wife. Hmm? He's the only one that said, "My husband is not your business. All you need to do is to hear the word of God." So he said, "Go, don't introduce one creed for me to be more fair. I will not use it." Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
The Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 31, "What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Nobody. All you need is the Lord with you. You don't need too much people around you. I tell you, it's even a distraction. It's a distraction. I'm not saying you should, if they must come, let them come to hear the truth. But try to back people around you to say you're a popular man of God. Wherever you go, they are like, Papa, Mama. So Mama, your small girl, that go to you. No. Don't Mama her. Let her be who she is. Don't Papa me. Don't perish me. Get the word of God from my mouth. If you tell the word from my mouth, I am happy with you. But try to Papa me, perish me, I will not accept it. And I believe my co-ministers will also accept it. And you also don't accept from anybody. So, are you hearing me? I think so.
Yes, sir.
Has men forgotten you? God will never forget you. Are you being rejected of men? I tell you the truth. God will never reject you. When you will know that God is powerful, let somebody reject you. And you start for the Lord, you see he will bring us somebody from nowhere. I have seen so many things. I am a witness to what God can do. When anybody starts thinking, we touch him or her, if you can be able to bear it at that moment, bear the pain, bear the rejection. I tell you, before you know it, the Lord will spring out. People of God, taste and see that God is good. Taste him and see. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 15, can a woman forget her own sucky child that she should not have compassion on the son of his womb? Yea, they may forget. If a woman now can forget his own son, is it me that I will say, sister, I told you not forget me? If God say, I saw some days ago, a woman tie her own son inside a bag for 3 days. Her own child, you gave birth to about 3 years. We are special gang. Tie him inside a bag. The child was there for 3 good days. Is it me? Such a woman will not kill. But yet we are not what? Forget you, says the Lord of hosts. People that love you may abandon you, but when you are right with God, he will never abandon you. People you seek to say, you are doing everything to please them, they can rebel against you. But God say, my son, my daughter, I will not abandon you. Now, who will you follow now? Is it a man, a woman that can, the devil can brainwash and will use their own son to do money ritual? Is it a human being who can slaughter their own blood for money ritual? You will follow? Or Christ that died for you? Is it man that could kill man, or Christ who died for you? Who will you follow? Who will you follow? Man? Man will make you and leave you empty. Man always want to take. Always want to take. It's only God that gives. The Bible says, for God so loved the world and he gave. Man? He dry you and empty you. So therefore, choose this day to live for the peace of man or to please God. Brethren, the Bible says in Psalm 27, I'm adding Psalms 27, 8 or 10. When thou sayest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, the first Lord will I seek. 9. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not. Neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. This is what me as a child should be crying for. Father, please don't forsake me. If the Lord abandon you and your words with you, you are doomed. If the presence of the Lord depart from you, and the whole universe are with you, you are doomed. All we should be concerned about is God's presence in our lives. It's not people leaving you. It's, am I still right with God? Is the presence of God still there? Is the Lord still with me? That is our concern. When my father, my mother, sister Ego, that person forsake me, is the Lord with me? If the Lord is with me, no problem. You know, this time, the Lord knows how to drag them. You put hook in her nose and bring it and bring her back again. That's God for you. That is God for you. That person that is hurting you. So long your heart is right, the Lord knows how to put hook in your head. They are human beings. The Bible, the heart of man is in my hand. Let the man and woman go. Except it's the will of God, they will not go. If not, will you know how to drag them. We drag them. See, this is where the truth is good. So, my sister, please overcome rejection. Overcome hatred. Don't say because they are hating you, you're going to blend with them now. So many people have gone to the grave. Why? Because they try to please people. So many people in school those days, when we were going to school those days, some people died trying to follow their friends. But God has been so kind that He has always been there to separate you and I from evil company. Maybe among that group, they are hating you. Why? Because they know you don't always join them, they're gossiping. Don't worry. Maybe your family are hating you. Why? Because they know when it's that way. When it comes to idolism, you are not with them. Don't worry. If you can start with God, the Lord one day will pull them out away from it. But if you not blend with them, the most fearful thing is this. If you try to please man, to make them happy, and you die in it, and that man now become a Christian tomorrow, you are finished. You expect that man in hell, he will never come. So women died to please their husband. They heard that. And you'll be surprised. Their husband now married another woman. This woman now converted him to Christianity. You will never see him in hell. The same thing with husband. Friends, ladies, please, I beg you, don't live your life to please people. You can please people by doing this, the right thing. If they are pleased for your good deed, because you are of God, bring it to God, but only few can do that. That's why the Bible says, the road that leads to heaven is narrow, and only few can find it. Matthew 7, 11 to 13. So, if you have one friend that trusts the God in you, just only one, that one is more than thousands out there that hate you. Hold that one tight. Somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
And if peradventure you don't also have anybody, it doesn't matter. Hold this one tight. Hold your God tight. At the end, the Lord be glorified in your life. I want to pray. Maybe you are falling because of what men are doing to you, because of what your husband is doing, because of what your wife is doing. You are not trying to please your husband now. You are trying to do those things your husband is saying. Let your husband, it's better your husband chase you away. When the Lord meets him by himself, he will come and beg you, come back, my wife. Now I know. That you not blend with him in that iniquity, he will never repent again. The Father, hold on to my heart for me. Maybe you are here, you are not considering. this pain is not getting too much. Let me go. No, people are not coming to the ministry because of my kind of message. Should I? Hey, Father, help me. Lord, for evil thinking about going back, have mercy upon me and help me.
Mm-hmm.
For evil thinking about, should I not start blending with him now? Father, I am sorry for putting you into an awful shape. Forgive me and grant me the grace to start strong. Open your mouth.
Thank you, Jesus. Have mercy upon my Jesus Christ, every prayer. Amen.
The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 12, it says, yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. I want us to pray. I said, Father, wherever I was trying to drop my godly lifestyle to avoid persecution, wherever I was trying to not try to start making my life to be like them, so that not to be persecuted, Lord, have mercy upon me. And we are going to pray, Lord, wherever I've ever bent my mouth so that I will not be hated by the person, you try to straighten it, you try to make the person happy. So that they will not say, hey, see this woman, Antonia, that means she's a bad woman. You try to not bend your mouth to one corner. So that they will love you. Lord, I'm sorry. Have mercy upon me. Grant me the grace to face any persecution that will come my way from now on. As a godly woman, as a godly man. Open your mouth and pray to God Almighty.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, King of glory and Lord, Father, please go for throughout the days of my life, oh God. Grant me the grace to bear every persecution. No matter where I go, what area is coming from, Father, grant the grace for me not to compromise. Father, please, just in the name of Jesus, that you fortify my mind, oh God. Fortify my mind with your grace, oh God. Help me, oh God.
I need your grace. You drop me that very day you bend your mouth. You drop that very day you saw your truth and you bend it. Your salvation was taken away from you. Bow that day. The day you bow, your salvation was taken away. You are not just moving. Say, Father, have I dropped my salvation trying to blend with the world? Have I dropped my salvation trying to please my husband? Trying to please my wife? Wrongly, please your wife. Your husband will do with the right thing. Let me do it so that I know it's wrong. Let me just do it to please him. Your salvation is no more there. Let me please Apostle Emmanuel. You know what he's saying is what he's doing is wrong. Well, please him. You have no salvation anymore. You have sold it out. Your seat has been taken away. The price of your salvation was that thing you did. Lord, search me. Where is that place I threw away my salvation? Trying to please man. And now I am still praying with people. I'm still fasting. I still come night and day. but I am no more with you anymore. Have mercy upon me. Restore my salvation. Create in me a clean heart today. Restore unto me the salvation that you gave me from the beginning. And now, as you give it to me, help me to keep it strong. Help me not to say it again. Help me not to put price tag on it again. My salvation is no more for sale for any reason. Open your mouth and pray if you get the prayer point. That will ever make me happy. What about you? Is that also your consolation? Is that also your conclusion? God bless you for that word. And that is what I think also. That is the only thing I have that can follow me to eternity, nothing else. Children will not follow us. Husband will not follow us. That woman that died with four children now, those children will not follow her. She went alone. Thank God.
Yes.
Brother, sisters, is there any that you had or follow you?
Nothing.
No, sir. The husband will not follow you. No way. The only thing you have that can follow you into eternity is your salvation.
Amen.
God bless you for that prayer point. I pray, God Almighty, you help me. Help you.
So Amen.
The only thing you have jealously to the end. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. I am the Lord has spoken. You can see now people who are born again. The Bible says, if the righteous scarcely be saved, what about you? This is Elizabeth, and she's crying. Why? Because of the danger of not being right with God. But what about you that you are totally out of the world, out of God? Please come back to Him now. Give your life to Jesus Christ. Let Him become the Lord of your life. Confess and say before Him. And maybe you are also here, you are vastly dead. You are offended. Please come back to the Lord God Almighty. Maybe you have gone back to those things that they want you to be doing. Run away from that thing and come back to the Lord. And it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Again, please, I want you to get baptized. Call on the men of God of the mountain. We will use that to baptize you and counsel you where necessary. And the grace to stand out, to be able to live a lonely life for the Lord, be able to live a life of rejection for the Lord, be able to live the life of lack, once for the sake of God, will be released upon you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, I thank you for your word that I've come for somebody here. You know what your daughter is going through. You know what your son is going through. That brought this word to comfort them. For them to know you are with them. For them to know, even as if the whole world is turning upside down them, you, the creator of the world and heaven, is with them. Lord, I've heard you. I've heard you. Help us to keep this word and run with it. Help us, oh God, never ever again to try to make the world to love us again. Help us not to cry, to weep again because the world are hating us. But help us to rejoice, for you love us, oh God. And I pray the grace, oh God, to always stand for the truth. That grace, oh God, to always stand out to please you. The release upon the man on the pulpit and the, your children on the pew in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God, have I spoken wrongly? Is there anyone of us here that when your word was coming was being distracted doing other things? Lord, please have mercy upon us, oh God. That song, what you have against you, against your children. But I made the world you said to deliver us to sell us to hell on that day. Please have mercy. Forgive us, oh God. For the end of this world, not condemn us on that day, but to be a propeller that will open the heaven, the gate of heaven, for me and for every soul on this mountain on the last day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray with thanksgiving.
Amen.
So, God, I bless you. This word, your heart is strong again now. Your mind is not set with him. Give a clap celebration.
Amen.
Amen. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, Mr. God. May the mighty God strengthen you